Toyo Eatery has finally opened its bakery, Panaderia Toyo, just a few doors down from its restaurant in Car Ivan Alley. Din Tai Fung has a gleaming new outlet in Power Plant Mall. The Japanese ramen chain Tsuda has added a branch in Bonifacio High Street. The city is full of new restaurants to try, parties to go to, caterers to check out, foodie gifts to give. There's so much to explore and to write about, but I feel that the most important news is the meal that consisted of a can of corned beef worth ₱31.50 that was stolen and eaten by Paul Matthew Tang Lau, a sales clerk working at a supermarket in STA. Anna. Missing details. As a news story, it leaves much to be desired. Not only is it not clear how he opened and ate the can of corned beef, how he was caught and, most importantly, why the supermarket decided to prosecute him to the full extent possible under the law, even under public scrutiny. What's missing are the details that could come only with a statement from the supermarket itself, which remains unnamed. At this writing, the miscreant still remains behind bars, despite having had bail posted. It's a story straight out of Les Miserables. At Christmas, we tell the truth, goes a line from Love Actually, one of the most improbable Christmas films, perhaps topped only by Die Hard. I feel nothing could be further from the truth. Christmas is a time when we lie, we pretend to be happy when we are not, we pretend to have money when we don't, we pretend the world is all right when it actually isn't. But Christmas brings out the truth about us even as we refuse to say it out loud. It shows us what we value as a society, how we think as a country, who we are as a people. Like the souls of the dead in Coco who wither and flicker away into dust when they are no longer remembered, the Philippines exists only as long as we continue to believe in it. At the end of 2017, it is chimerical and decaying, just a passport, and an annoyingly restrictive one at that, a group of islands where we live out our wretched lives, and a groaning government bureaucracy out to get you at every turn. How can we be proud to be Filipinos when we are capable of such gut-wrenching cruelty to our fellow countrymen? Shattered land, we have become a people who value power over empathy, guile over smarts, money over accomplishments. Rules are for suckers. Ours is a shattered land, of lives that could have been led, of loves that could have been had, if we had not been stuck in traffic. We overpay for the necessities at the cost of the essentials, reading, nights out at the cinema, huddling with our friends. Our God is from the Old Testament patriarchal, angry, vengeful. It is the sort of God who would smite you for wrongdoing, or, for that matter, put you in jail for stealing a can of meat when you're starving. It may come as a surprise that I'm actually ambivalent about the unyielding refusal of clemency to the thief. Not that I applaud the supermarket owners for harshness, but because I don't wish to diminish the humanity of the miscreant for being a victim of circumstances. He stole, as he admitted, because he thought if he were caught he would simply be docked the equivalent of the price from his day's wages, or at worst he'd be sacked.